Hello everyone, you are watching the Simple Designers YouTube channel, and in today's video we are going to answer the most requested thing in our comment section: how do you add highlights and shadows to your line art illustration? In this video we are going to show you the techniques that we use, the shortcuts behind, and everything you need to learn to do it by yourself. So to show you how to add highlights and shadows, we need to design something first. So today we are going to design a MacBook icon, something that looks like this. As you see, we have two versions of a MacBook icon. The one on the left is kind of empty and not that great. The one on the right though has more depth and more personality, and I think you spotted the difference. So without further ado, let's get started right away with Illustrator to show you how to do this effect. As you see, we are inside Illustrator, and the first thing to do here is to create a new document. So let's go to File, New, and create a new document. Then we are faced with this window to select the document settings. We will keep everything as default for now. The only thing that we need to change in this window is the width and height for our canvas. So let's go with an Instagram picture size, for example. So let's go with a 1080 by 1080 resolution. Now it's time to create the base for our illustration. So we are going to start by a small rectangle. Let's say something around 160 by 90. Then I'm going to select my shape, hold my shift key and scale it a little bit. Next, I'm gonna give my shape a fill color, and for that I'm gonna choose this light gray color. Now I'm gonna add a stroke. So for that I'm gonna select my shape, go to properties and click on stroke. Then I'm gonna increase the weight or the thickness of my stroke. I usually go with something around 6 for this document size. Then I'm gonna make sure to select these two options, the round caps and round joins. Then I'm gonna choose a color for my stroke. So I'm gonna go with this bluish dark gray color. Then I'm gonna select my shape. Then I'm gonna choose my direct selection tool, so shortcut key A for that. Then I'm gonna select this borders and round them to, let's go with 10 points. What I'm going to do next is to create something similar to the Apple logo. So let's not complicate things and draw a small ellipse in the center of my shape. Then I'm going to hold my Alt key and drag this ellipse to the left to create another duplicate. Now I'm going to select these two objects together and go to Pathfinder panel. Then I'm going to select this minus front option. And as you see, we are left with this shape as the logo, so let's give it a white color. As you see, we have basically finished creating the icon. Now we need to add the proper highlights and shadows, and let's give it more details. In order to create shadows or highlights, we need to prepare our shape first. In other words, we need to separate the fill from the stroke, and I'll show you why in a minute. So let's open the layers panel to see our layers and better understand. Then I'm going to select my shape and duplicate it. Now as you see, we have two shapes on top of each other. We have the top one and we have also this bottom one. So I'm going to select the top shape and remove the fill and keep the stroke. Then I'm going to do the exact opposite for the bottom shape. So instead we will remove the stroke and keep the fill. And now we have the stroke and the fill on different layers. This will allow us later to add different layers between the fill and the stroke. So let's name these layers accordingly. Now it's time to add the shadows, so let's use the pen tool to create a small shadow. Now that we have created the shape, let's give it the same color as the stroke, and let's decrease the opacity to 10%. And also let's make sure that this shadow layer is between the stroke and the fill, so let's send it to the back below the stroke. As you see, we have created a basic shadow effect with just a few clicks, so let's do the same for the highlights. First, I'm going to select the fill layer and duplicate it two times, and I'm going to show you why in a second. As you see, we have three shapes, so let's select these two objects on top and intersect them together, and for that, I'm going to use my favorite tool inside Illustrator, the Shape Builder. Working with Shape Builder is pretty easy. Just click on parts that you want to keep, and you hold Alt key and click on parts that you want to get rid of. So let's select my two objects, Then let's select my shape builder, and then I'm gonna hold my alt key and drag on these two objects to remove them. Now I'm gonna release my alt key and click on this object to keep it. Now let's give it a white color and decrease the opacity to something around 25%. And as you see, here is my highlight. So let's send it to the back between the stroke and the fill layer. Now that we have the basic highlights and shadows done, it's time to add some extra accents. And it's up to you to imagine different accents to add. For this type of illustration, I'm gonna use my pen tool and try to create some random different small shapes to make my illustration unique and have its own personality and identity. And aside from that, I think we finished our MacBook illustration, and as you see, with just a few clicks and tricks. So here is our final illustration with all the highlights and shadows. So hope that you liked it. Hope that you enjoyed this video. If so, make sure to leave your feedback in the comment section. And with that said, see you in the next one, and keep it simple, designers.
Hold up, baby, I can't sit beside you while you're going on about your simple life. Nothing left you thinking that maybe you're not different.